Have you ever noticed black lines on the top and the bottom part of your TV or projector screen? Do you know why does it occur and why does it keep changing from content to content or from the channel to channel that you watch? Now all this is happening because of aspect ratios. Aspect ratios is something that you must not have heard much about, but I'm sure you have heard about something called as resolution while buying video displays or projector screens. Now in this particular video, we are going to help understand the various types of aspect ratios that are available and how does it change from content to content or from device to device, and why understanding aspect ratios is very important in your entire viewing experience. And lastly, we are also going to see the relationship of aspect ratio with the resolution. Because believe me or not, if you are a movie buff or you are a TV fanatic, understanding these aspect ratios is very, very crucial for your entire viewing experience. Hello everyone, my name is Tanmay Mehta, your home cinema consultant or home theater wale bhaiya. And in this particular video, like always, we are going to bring enough value to you so that you are in a better stage to make well-informed, wise and correct decisions, as we have been doing since the last few years at Touchwood Automations with me and my team. So in case you find this particular information helpful and valuable, then do not forget to hit the subscribe button right now and stay subscribed for our next upcoming videos as well. Now let us first understand the aspect ratio. Aspect ratio in a very, very simple language is the proportion of the width of the image to the height of the image. Now when I'm talking about this image, it does not mean it is a stationary image. It can be relevant to a moving image as well. For instance, the video that you're watching is 16:9 aspect ratio. Now understanding this aspect ratio is very important to overall optimize your viewing experience. And one of the most important factor to consider here is that it is not mandatory that the content aspect ratio needs to match with your device's aspect ratio. For instance, if you're watching this particular video on your laptop, the laptop can be of aspect ratio 16:10, whereas this particular video is in 16:9 format. Similarly, if you're watching it from your mobile phone, you also need to check what is the aspect ratio of your mobile phone, because again, it is not necessary to match with the aspect ratio of the content that you're watching. Now to know your aspect ratio of the mobile phone devices that you're using, simply go to Google, type in your manufacturer and model number along with aspect ratio, and let me know in the comments below as to what is the aspect ratio of your particular handset device. Now if aspect ratio is very, very clear to you, let us now move on to understand the difference between the aspect ratio and resolution and how do they correlate as well. Now we all have come across this term called resolution, and this resolution for us in a very, very simple language meant clarity. But why does it define clarity? To make it simple, let us go back to our old TVs. Now our old TVs were of an aspect ratio of 4:3, wherein we had 800 vertical lines and 600 horizontal lines. And these horizontal lines created squares which were called as pixels. Now less amount of pixels means less clarity. For instance, when you look at the modern day 16:9 TVs, which came after these square boxes, these were rectangular flat panels and they had 1920 vertical lines and 1080 as the horizontal lines. Similarly, when 4K pictures or Ultra HD displays started coming in, the resolution in that was 3840 and the horizontal lines were 2160. So these resolution started increasing and it eventually started giving you more clearer picture. Now if you go back to the same old square box TV which had 800 by 600 lines, when you put this 800 by 600 and divide it by common denominators, you will see that the aspect ratio of these lines is coming down to 4:3. Now this 4:3 format is that of your square old cathode ray TVs, and when we compare the 1920 by 1080 and you, let's say, divide it by 120 as the common denominator, you will see 16 and 9 as the two numbers that you get for these lines. And this 16 by 9 is nothing but the aspect ratio of that particular display. Similarly, Ultra HD has got 3840 by 2160, which again comes down to 16:9. Now this 16:9 is the aspect ratio of a full HD resolution TV. This exactly, my friends, is the relationship between resolution and the aspect ratio of any particular display that you are watching or consuming today. Now that we have seen the difference between the aspect ratios of 4:3 and 16:9, we can come to a conclusion that most of our modern day displays wherein we watch TV or we watch our regular home cinema content is in 16:9 format. It can be with regards to the TV or it can be with regards to your projector screen. But guess what? Even when you're watching on these particular rectangular panels, you are still seeing black bands on the top as well as at the bottom. And why is it happening? Well, the reason why is it happening is because most of the content that we are consuming on these 16:9 displays is of 2.35:1 aspect ratio, which is called as the Cinemascope aspect ratio. Now, these Cinemascope are also referred as ultra-wide. Now, the reason why they are called ultra-wide is because the width is bigger, but the height is smaller. So, for instance, when you're watching this 2.35:1 content on a 16:9 display, the height is going to get reduced by a few inches on a flat panel TV, which is up to 43-55 inches. But when you talk about 100-120 inches projector screen, these black bands are going to increase in the size, and that is where you would see 66 inches minimum as the consumption of these black bands while watching your 2.35:1 ratio screen, a ratio content. Now, for these reasons, it is very, very important to understand that how can you have best of the both worlds by not compromising on either of the quality. And when I'm talking about this, we are talking about which is the best aspect ratio that you need to have in your particular home cinema system or home cinema room, depending upon your specific needs and preferences. Now, if you are already confused as to that, I now know what is the difference between 16:9 and 2.35:1 and what is the reason why am I seeing those black bands on my TV or projector screen. Now, if your question is that which ideally is the aspect ratio that I need to rely on, or how can I change my display, or do I need to buy a different projector or a TV screen? Well, hold on to your thoughts, because in this particular section, we are going to understand that which aspect ratio is the most suitable for your home cinema experience. Now, again, this is going to depend upon your particular specific needs and preferences, and my job is to only highlight them for you so that you can make your decisions very rightly. Okay, so moving on. In a 16:9 format or in a 16:9 aspect ratio devices, as mentioned earlier, when you watch a 2.35:1 ratio content, you are going to see black bands on the top and the bottom. Now, this is applicable for almost 95% of the content that you and I consume, especially on the OTT platforms. Now, these OTT platforms, if you're watching, let's say, stand-up comedies, or you're watching some live sports event or news channel, then that is the time when your screen will be consumed completely, which means that your entire 16:9 will then have an image. But the moment you play a movie, the height will get reduced to 2.35:1. Now, this will also change based upon the input media devices. So, for instance, if you are playing a Fire TV stick on your projector screen, the Fire TV stick home screen will occupy the entire screen, because the Fire TV stick home screen or the content menu search is designed in a 16:9 format. But the moment you enter a particular movie, you will see that the height is getting reduced and you're having the black bands. That is because the content that you're still consuming is in a 2.35:1 format. And to avoid these things, what one may also do in case movie is your primary experience or is your primary go-to thing, then you can opt for going for a projector screen which is 2.35:1. Now, having said that, you also need to see the compatibility of your TV of your projector screen, because for TVs you really don't have much choice. You today get maximum TVs available only in 16:9 format, whereas for projectors you have got various aspect ratios wherein you can change it through the button. So, for instance, most of the DLP projectors give you this liberty of changing the aspect ratios while you watch the content, but for LCD projectors like Epson, they may not give you this facility. So let us simplify the projector game over here. Now imagine that you're watching a movie from your projector screen and your screen size is 16:9. The display resolution of your projector is also by default set on 16:9. Now in these cases, if your projector gives you an option of adjusting the content to 2.35:1, or if the content it plays also gives you the 2.35:1 aspect ratio, you can opt to buy a 2.35:1 screen and adjust the entire width of the screen with your image. In this case though, the menu button wherein you see the entire content menu and the search of that particular primary content source will go beyond the screen on the top as well as bottom. And that is where a very, very important factor comes into picture, and that is of lens memory or lens preset. Now this lens memory or lens preset is a most important feature while shopping for your high-end projectors, wherein you can have a memory feature by adjusting the screen to 16:9 as well as to 2.35:1. In a very, very simple language, let's say if you buy a 2.35:1 aspect ratio screen and you have a projector which has got lens memory options, wherein you can create two presets. The first preset is for your 16:9 format. The second preset is for your 2.35:1 format. In this case, when your content is in 2.35:1, it will go to the second preset of 2.35:1, and your screen will get fully consumed with regards to the height as well as with the width. But the moment you go back to some other content which is 16:9 format, let's say a match or a news channel, then in that case you can just press the lens memory button and go back to preset 1, wherein you will have black bands on the side of the screen, but the height of the screen will completely get occupied with your 16:9 content. Now this is how, with the lens memory and lens preset, you can take care of your CinemaScope viewing and still get the best of both the worlds. But having said that, this is a feature which is available only in certain high-end projectors. So for that reason, if you're buying one of the entry-level Full HD or 4K projectors, this may not be a necessary feature that you would get. And in such cases, going for a 16:9 ratio screen is the most logical thing to do. Now, I've also come across many people who have bought 4:3 ratio screens, because what you guys do is that you compare the product screen prices online, and when you just type in 100 inches screen on Amazon, this primary screen that they are telling you is all in 4:3 aspect ratio and not in 16:9 aspect ratio. So for that very reason, understanding these aspect ratios is very important in making your decisions for your home cinema equipments. Now this is all about viewing experience and how aspect ratios really matter in your viewing experience. But do you know something? Well, your aspect ratios can also have a very, very deeper impact on the sound system. Now, the reason why I'm saying that is, let's imagine if you're going for a 2.35:1 aspect ratio ultra wide or CinemaScope screen. In such cases, when the width of the screen is high, you would want to have speakers which will also have that wide sound stage. And in such cases, you would want to install the front speakers as far as possible so that they can match to the screen expectations and also create that wide sound field, just like your wide viewing experience. Similarly, when you're going for a 16:9 ratio screen, you want to ensure that the height or the room volume in terms of the height is maintained, and that is where the height channels can play a very, very crucial role in going for these 16:9 ratio screens and matching them with your desired sound systems. So your sound system setup or your surround speaker setup would very much depend upon your screen size and the screen aspect ratios, and that is why understanding that how aspect ratios impact your sound experience is very, very important, because overall the sound and the video is going to give you that immersive experience that you all desire for. So in a nutshell, don't just buy anything that has been given to you on a piece of paper. It is very, very important that while shopping for your home cinema experience, it is important to know all these technical terminologies, and I hope that this particular video has helped you simplify the logic of aspect ratio with the resolutions that you watch, and also which aspect ratios are the best ones to enjoy in your home cinema system. in case you want some more exciting information about the difference between the 2.35:1 ratio, the 16:9 ratio and the IMAX ratio, and what is it that makes IMAX so special, then let me know in the comments below so that we can have a separate video done on the same. And in case you need an expert solution for your particular home cinema requirements, then all you have to do is go on the link on the top, as well as that is shared in the description below, and get in touch with me and my team to help you design some of the fantastic home cinema solutions in your room, in your city, and in the desired target price range that you all wanted to have. That's it from my end in this particular video, guys. If you found this particular video helpful, and now that you know the reason why you see those black patches on the top and bottom, then make sure to share this video with the right people who are still wondering that why am I seeing this, and ask them as well as you to do subscribe to our channel to stay in touch with us for more such valuable and insightful videos. Thank you so much for watching. I, Tanmay Mehta, your home cinema consultant or home theater wale bhaiya, will see you again in my next video. Thank you.